may look tempting maybe to go canoeing, rafting, but beware.
Yeah, even the experts won't go out on the water when it's like this. News 5's Karen Johnson takes us out to the river, new at 6.
With the recent rain we've had lately and the high water, the only place you and your canoe should be this weekend is on dry land.
Everybody's got spring fever right now. They're itching to get out on the rivers, they're just to get outdoors in general.
But no matter how brightly the sun shines, or soothing the sounds of nature are, danger is just one splash away.
But it's very dangerous. I would write off any rivers in the tri-state for this holiday Easter weekend.
The Morgans, who've pioneered the canoeing industry in the area, say the greatest dangers, hitting debris and then struggling in the cold, fast water.
You could get beat to death.
Even hanging trees can be deadly when rivers are this high.
You know, we're looking at a typical example of a strainer situation on the rivers.
Normally, this tree would be on dry land and 20 feet over your head.
At higher water levels, it is now down above the surface of the river, and any boat hitting that is going to immediately capsize.
And once you tip over and start floating down the river in these conditions,
rescue attempts become very, very difficult.
The Morgans say if they're not willing to send anyone down the river,
I would not get on this river right now.
Neither should you.
But it's private individuals that haven't been out yet and see a sunny day like today and start making plans. If you're their wife, tell them, not this weekend, honey, you're mowing the grass.
And the Morgans say as soon as it's safe to put your canoes back in the river, they'll post it on their website, and you can find the link by going to our site, WLWT.com, and clicking on the As Seen On section. At Fort Ancient, Karen Johnson, News 5.